Success in biotech industry depends on our hardcore understanding of subject, practical aspects of applying those hardcore principles in the lab, and then innovating on some unseemingly unrelated things, combining it and finding a newer way of doing it. Welcome to the world of biotechnology. That's how this world works. We cannot ignore the importance of wet lab hands-on. But today I'm not just here to tell you about the importance of wet lab hands-on, and I'm also going to tell you why it is very important to get the benefits from the right lab. That's something which is very, very important. So before I tell you the importance of hands-on, here's something I want to share with all of you. If you are getting the hands-on from some lab which is no recognition, then they may not have the right exposure or the right mix of instrument and chemicals which will help you grow. So that is where Biotechnica brings up some exclusive hands-on training for all of you, which I'm going to tell you during my video today. But to start with, the first point which I want to make is benefits is huge. You cannot ignore hands-on. The first benefit which I would like to bring to you all is practical skill development. So as you can see here, practical skills. Now, I studied the structure of cholesterol in my theory, right? But how that particular cholesterol will interact, with a particular organic solvent or inorganic solvent, at what concentration it will really react. Now, these are all things that's practical, right? Now, whenever you will do practical, you will get immense exposure of those dimensions of theory which has never been discussed while theory was being taught. And that is why practical is very important, because you learn by yourself, by doing it yourself. And that's the best way of doing, you know, learning. When you do it yourself, that builds your self-confidence. And that is where the second point comes in. And the second point for all of you is practical problem-solving approach. Okay. Now, no book can tell you the practical aspect. Like, they will tell you about ectopic pacemaker, right? But they will not tell you that if you are drinking coffee at the same time having non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agent, it can cause ectopicity. So that's what really happens. This is a practical thing, right? Which is not there in the book. There are two ways to learn practical things. One is by reading in between the lines, correlating two theories and coming to a newer conclusion, or just by doing the practical in the lab. Practical problem solving comes with due course of time. I am sure you must be remembering the first day when you tried to focus that microscope, or when you tried to do that titration and the results didn't come, right? And then you realize, okay, this is how you have to do it. This is how you have to titrate. This is how you have to focus. So this practical, you know, hands-on problem solving skill can never be taught in a theory class. So that's where the second point is, practical problem solving you learn during hands-on. And again, if you are in a small lab where all these facilities are not there, advanced facilities, or the guide or the person who is there, he is not having that exposure, he will never be able to guide you when there is a practical problem. Okay. And practical problem solving skills comes with experience. The more you do, the better you get at it. So that's the second point. Now let's jump on to the third point, and that is attention to detail. Now, for example, if you are working in a lab, you need to work in a sterilized environment, but you are not realizing that walking in with your shoes, or somebody just walked in by mistake, that is hampering your experiment result. Attention to detail, creating protocol so that the existing protocols don't get violated. That's attention to detail. Attention to detail, you know, helps you achieve your experiment results faster. Otherwise, you keep wondering whole of your life, why I'm not getting results while others are getting results. The truth is, you're not paying attention to detail. And that's the third point you learn when you do hands-on wet lab training and under the right person. And the right person, I'm going to tell you who it is very, very shortly. Now, the fourth point is, you learn teamwork. Like, okay, for example, right now I'm shooting. So it's not just that I am shooting. There is a cameraman behind who is shooting. And then there will be a graphic designer who will edit this video. So what this is? This is teamwork. The same way, when you will work in a lab, what will happen? There will be a guide, there will be other students, and then there will be a group target that this is what you have to do and achieve. And then you work in an environment where somebody is preparing the reagent, somebody is doing the measurement, somebody is at the weighing scale, and somebody is looking after the protocols, whether it is being followed, somebody is recording results. All of that. So that's teamwork, right? You learn teamwork when you practice teamwork, and the best way to practice teamwork is getting into the lab and getting your hands dirty. Now, the fifth point which I have for all of you, very important point here, that is practice of lab safety. 70% of the lab accidents in India are never reported. In fact, not 70, I should say 96% of the lab safety issues are never reported. Lab accidents are never reported. In fact, we were a part of the committee which was building a report on lab safety in India. And unfortunately, that report could never be published, and the government got changed, and that report is out of the window now. But yeah, practice lab safety. How do you, right? Now, unless you've got the shock, you will not know that electricity will give you the shock, right? The same way, unless you've violated some lab safety protocols and you've burned your fingers, you will not know it. But at the same time, whenever you enter the lab, there will be a laboratory manual, laboratory protocols, laboratory to-dos, precautions, because there are several types of lab, BSL-2, BSL-3 labs. So the more you are practicing the lab safety, the better you are getting at it. And that is where your chances of errors are lesser. And when the chances of errors are lesser, that is where you will win the world of science. Now, I remember an incident when I got a call from a student from CCMB Hyderabad, and he had to discontinue his PhD after 4 years of hard work. You know why? Because what data he took was wrong. The data was wrong because he had no appropriate or enough hands-on experience. He qualified CSIRNet on the basis of theory, and later on, he did mistakes in his practical and he could not achieve his PhD. He had to discontinue his PhD because the money ran out, because the PI was angry, because he never achieved the results, because he was wrong in the wet lab. So that's where benefit is very, very important. You have to focus on wet lab. The next one is familiarity with lab instruments. Like, okay, if you don't know how a weighing scale works, if you don't know how the microscope works, PCR works, right, the sequencing works, you will not be able to do it, right? So all the molecular biology techniques, all the biochemistry techniques, all this is very important, the cell biology techniques. You have to have the familiarity with the various instruments which are manually operated, automatically operated, and also should be able to withdraw results from the data which you get from this. So that's very important, familiarity with lab instruments you get when you do wet lab, hands-on from the right lab. The next one is, of course, it enhances your career opportunities. You see, will I hire someone who doesn't know computers? No, right? Same way, will the industry hire someone who doesn't know the basics of lab skills? No. And that is where there's a huge demand for trained manpower for the lab. And what big companies do is they will wait for people to gain experience in small companies and they'll take it. And what small companies will do is they will wait for the person to gain the lab hands-on skills. And that is where Biotechnica comes into picture. We have excellent wet lab hands-on in IISc incubated labs, JNU incubated labs, and one of the largest and oldest labs in India, that is SHRM Biotechnology, there also. So three labs we have, one is in Kolkata, one is in Delhi, and one is in Bangalore. These are the three labs where we are providing you wet lab hands-on. We are starting molecular biology techniques internship hands-on as well as online. So if you cannot go to these labs, you can always do the online internship and you can have an online virtual hands-on. But I will highly recommend if you can go to the lab and do wet lab hands-on, that will be a great add-on. That's where it will improve your employability, because whether you want to get a job in a small company or a large company, they all need this particular wet lab techniques, hands-on. The next point, eighth point, again, very, very important for all of you, is failure engineering. You have to fail 100 times to know why you failed, how you can fail and prevent that failure, right? I remember the first year, complete year, when I entered my biology lab, I didn't know how to focus a microscope. I was very bad in preparing slides, and my teacher used to literally curse me whenever he saw me because of my bad hands-on skill, right? Now, why did that happen? Because no basics was there. But the more I failed, the more I learned. The more I failed, the more I learned, the more I learned, the better I got at it. Failure engineering. The more you fail, it engineers you towards success. So unless you have failed 100 times, you will not know how to succeed the 101st time. And that is where you need hands-on wet lab training. And that is where the real skill set comes. Next point for all of you, the ninth point is developing a critical thinking and analytical skills. Now, if you look at it, the lab temperature may not have a direct impact on your results, but it can definitely play a big role in your results, right? Now, you are thinking, why exactly I'm not getting results? You are thinking on everything while it's just the basic lab temperature. But you could analyze, okay, no, there is a difference. But when I'm going outside, the temperature is different. But for this particular chemical, we need to maintain that temperature. And that is why probably I'm not getting results. So you'll be able to critically think and analyze. And how do you do that? Failure engineering. The more you fail, the more you learn. Critically think, analyze the data, and then come to a conclusion. Okay, this is the reason it is not working. And then you make it work. You know, I remember a quotation, a particular thought which my mentor shared with me is the sooner and the more you fail early in your life, in whatever you do, the better you will get at it in the next part of your life, which is adulthood and when you are stabilizing your career, right? And that is where this comes like a rocket, okay? So please make sure that you're doing hands-on under good lab, good guidance, and I can definitely recommend a lot of labs to all of you, in fact. Now, the next point for all of you is creative problem solving, right? Now, you look at this. Critical and creative, what are the difference? Critical thinking, right? So you could think and analyze, but now you don't have resources. For example, you don't have AC in the lab and you need to maintain a temperature below 22 degrees centigrade, right? You are like, okay, how do you do that? Right. So should I perform this particular experiment in a different lab because I don't have AC here? I can't maintain the temperature. Instead, you have the fridge in your lab refrigerator. You use that to conduct the experiment and you succeed. So what you actually did? You critically thought, but now you creatively change the way you do it. So you actually did a jugaad where you don't have resources. You have lack of resources. You use that as a superpower. Right. And I do that every day in Biotechnica. Like, for example, this thing was not working and we figured it out how to do that in the camera. Right. So what happens? You become a creative problem solver. The more problems you solve, critically you analyze, that's where you get better at it. So that's where, again, benefit of hands-on wet lab training. Last part is confidence building. As you can see here, you know, I have given 10,000 talks, more than, I think, 600 plus or 1,000 plus videos I've shot till date. That gives me the confidence to talk. Same way, when you will walk into a lab and if you're not familiar, you are nervous, you don't know what to do, you will not have the confidence, right? And that is where your employer is going to kick you out, right? He'll say, okay, you have knowledge, but still, please get out because you don't know basic lab etiquettes, basic lab skills, right? So that is where it builds your confidence. In fact, when you'll go for the job interview, that is where when you'll talk with confidence, that confidence will further become a magnet to attract the employer to hire you. Now tell me, is it not important? Of course it is. Now, one very important thing is you must do the hands-on under the right person who is willing to go an extra mile to train you. Now, generally, hands-on are in government labs. Now, what happens is the government scientists are very busy people. Of course, they have to meet a target. So they have organized a training. I'm not saying it is bad, but many places I have seen. So they may not be able to give the right, wet lab skill set. That is where what we did is we have tied up with IISc incubated lab as well as JNU incubated lab, as well as one of the oldest labs in the country in Kolkata, that is SHRM Biotechnologies. These three laboratories are at your disposal. You can walk in anytime and you can just say Biotechnica and my name and they will accept you. Okay. You may have to just pay for the chemical charges. If you are a part of the ARM scholarship, if you are an ARM scholar or a JEET scholar, you have to just pay the chemical charges and then they'll give you everything else free of cost and you will be able to do hands-on. Okay. Hands-on complete wet lab, whether it's molecular biology, sequencing, anything, okay, CRISPR, you can go in and do your experiments. And these scientists are really experienced people, you know, 60 plus years of experience in, you know, training students, combined experience, and they have several experts from out of India as well as within India. They have the right tools, right instruments, and the right mindset to train. So we are starting a molecular biology techniques internship from 28th of May. If you are interested in this hands-on or virtual hands-on internship, then apply on the link given in the description. Remember, benefits are tremendous for wet lab hands-on, but only from the right lab, only from the right mentor, only from the right guru. And I highly recommend you joining the molecular biology techniques internship, because there Dr. Tithi, Dr. Tanushree, and Dr. Farhan Zamir sir is going to come live to train you on lab techniques, wet lab techniques, and then they will be giving you the hands-on as well. So thank you so much for watching this video. See you soon in a lab as a successful scientist. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.